With Cao Cao's generals in pursuit, Liu Bei made his escape to Jianling. Following that, Cao Cao suffered a crushing defeat to Liu Bei and Sun Quan at Qingdi and brought the conquest to a halt. In the meantime, Liu Bei took Yi province, thrusting the nation into the age of the three kingdoms of Wei, Wu, and Zhu. Rumors that Cao Cao, now a chancellor, was vying for the throne caused tumult throughout the land. Also, as if meaning to take advantage of such domestic troubles, Sun Quan came to assault Hefei. Xiahou rode his horse toward the battlefield to put an end to this enemy.
Master Xiahou, do you know what our lord truly plans?
The rumors about the Emperor?
Exactly. Firstly, what does he think of this? Is this even what he wants to have happen?
Who can say? I have known him for ages, and even I cannot say what he is thinking most times. And yet, whether he accepts the throne or not, I believe that he will remain himself. He won't change. That is why we too must not change. As commanding officers, we'll fulfill our duties. The enemy will bring its main force against us. Your duty is to stop them.
Indeed it is. I can see why our lord has kept you by his side so long.
Victim is falling. fallen to my blade. Another victim has fallen to my blade. Another victim has fallen to my blade.
Amazing! We will have to display our strength as well.
A true warrior indeed. You will carry our honor across the land.
This one is heroic. I guess I need to pick up the pace.
Hold them back! It's do or die! Face me at the gate! What a disaster! I have no excuse for troubling you in this rabbit.
The enemy is very strong. We are being forced back.
A lot of fun. See.
Another victim has fallen to my blade. I will show no mercy.
You believe your wits are a match for mine?
Die! Thank you for your help.
Another victim has fallen to my blade. We won. Good work. Cao Cao would have had our heads if we had lost Heifei. These results should suffice for now.